Holy moly. Holy cannoli, dude. I finally got around to recording this. I think the microphone's too close. Let me just move this over. I finally got around to doing this podcast. Wow. Go me. I finally did something useful. Wow. Congratulate everyone. Give me a clap. Yeah. First podcast, and I finally stopped putting it off for a good while. Yeah. Welcome to my podcast. My name is the 13th Revenant, or you could just simply call me Kyle. It's short for Kyle. I know it's very long, but welcome to the Dead Serious podcast, where I talk about random things posted at random times for no particular reason other than just to do it. Also, a lot of the pictures for the thumbnails for my video for my podcast is gonna pretty much be based off of old 80s to 90s albums, because I hate modern music. Unless it's a good soundtrack from a good AAA video game or something. Or just any video. Okay, I'm a big video game nerd, alright? That's the basic idea, alright? We're just talking about whatever. Well, I'm talking about whatever. You can kind of go into some kind of comments and probably say like, oh, timestamp, this is funny. This made me laugh a lot. Oh, funny. It's a funny joke. I mean, I'm not entirely alone. My skeleton funny man is over here. Hey, funny man. How good is this? Okay, well that was pretty rude. Can you not be that rude? All right. Gosh, dude. Funny man's in a weird mood, dude. He's in a weird mood. I think it's because he can't speak. Yeah, he can't speak. I'm sorry. Funny man, did I hurt your feelings? I'm sorry, funny man. It's all right. Okay, cool. We're on the same page. All right. Let's get into topics of discussion. Did you ever want to know why a pickle can be both scary and the funniest thing you've ever seen? Now, we're going to talk about this, right? So, pickles. Why are people so interested in pickles? I don't know. There's this weird fascination with pickles that I don't understand. I'm part of that fascination. Something about pickles is just so weird. I personally, when I eat pickles, I want to vomit because it tastes bad. I don't know. It's probably something with the vinegar and the fact that it's a plant and I don't like plants. My diet is either carnivorous or something akin to an Oompa Loompa, because, yeah, I can only, like, really eat meat and chocolate and selective spices and sauces. It's weird. I can't have toppings on things. I can't. If you were to ask me to eat ketchup or mustard or something, I can't. And I can't just have mayo on things. Except for this, like, killer pork chops that I can make. It's one of the only recipes I remember my mom and dad teaching me. And I love it so dearly. And it's pretty much, and it's called cheesy pork chops. And I did a whole stream on this. Pretty much what you do. So once you get your pork chops prepared, right? You get them washed because you don't want no, like, dirty blood all over it, you know. And you don't want, like, the meat to be dirty because they're all in them packages. You don't know what's in them packages. You don't know what is on those things, you know. What you do, you spread mayo on it, you know. The mayo's going to be, like, a delicious glue, right? Then you just take, like, Parmesan cheese or whatever. I'm still referring to the stream. I'll probably link it in the description below with a timestamp. Essentially, what is going to happen, you eat the... you put the cheese, you dump the cheese on it, all right? You make like a thick layer of cheese, you know? It has to be thick because otherwise the cheese, when it melts, it's going to be a skinny layer. So what you need to do is build up the layer by just pretty much essentially what you do with the mag dump, you just dump it all on there. Don't make like Mount Everest out of the cheese, but at least make like just make some good hills, all right? Just make some good hills. Maybe shake it, maybe shake the pork chop, make it level, you know? It's going to be pretty cool. Put in the oven set to like 350 Fahrenheit because I'm an American, and cook that sucker for like 35-38 minutes, and boom. Make sure the pork chops aren't too wet, because if they do, they're going to dry out so terribly. They're going to dry out very badly. So, going back, because I digress a lot, pickles. So, why is it the scared? Okay, so, think of this. So, pickles are pretty much like, I think they used to be cucumbers or something. Or like sea cucumber. I can't remember. I think they're like just like vinegared things. I don't know. Like when you pickle something, it's probably like in vinegar. I don't know. I don't know how pickles are made. All right. I'm tiny brain when it comes to cooking stuff. All right. You should already know this. So, they're pickles. I think they're like the next evolution of cucumbers under certain circumstances. And cucumbers are what cats are low-key afraid of, or high-key, depending on which cat you have. I think it's something with the smell, or maybe because it's shaped in a certain way. I don't know. But, I don't know, maybe a long time ago, cucumbers used to be sentient, and they went to war with cats. And, like cats had these cool, like, chariots and stuff. And they'd be like meow 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 meow, which means this is Sparta. And just Sparta kicks them into like whatever you can grind cucumbers in, maybe like in a blender, you know? That'd be cute, you know. And after this whole war, all the cats have like low key PTSD. So when like the grand majority of them see a cucumber, especially dropped right next to them, they're gonna freak out and they're gonna be like, holy moly, and just start jumping around. Like, all crazy. They're gonna go, what is this? What is this thing? Whoa, flashbacks. Whoa! Some kind of, like low-key, hidden PTSD. I don't know. Or, like, post-traumatic, post-cucumber stress disorder. PCSD. Something like that. Hell is the... So, I don't know. There's also another pickle, and we call this thing a devil's joe. And yes, this is a video game reference. Just deal with it, all right? So, what is a devil's joe, you may ask? Well, so think of getting Godzilla. Make it smaller, right? Make Godzilla a bit smaller. Then get a pickle, you know. Make Godzilla out of the pickle, right? Okay. Now, what I want you to do is get a vape. Yeah, a vape. Make sure, like, the vape, make sure, like, when you do the smoke, you know, it's kind of black and electric, you know? So when you, like, when you take a whole puff of it, and then you, like, go, you know, what blows out, it's like this black smoke. And there's, like, red electricity going through it. And boom, you got yourself a devil show. Also, like, maybe at some points, you know, like, when it does the breath thing, it's, like, part of the pickle where the vape is in. It, like, starts glowing red, you know? Yeah. That's a devil show. It's fear. It's fear. It makes me scared sometimes when I fight it. I love its theme so much. I love it so much. It reminds me of Godzilla, but the thing that's Godzilla is in, like, Monster Hunter World. That's really him. That's really Godzilla. But we're not talking about Godzilla. We're talking about oversized pickles. Now, let me tell you what this pickle can do. Let me tell you what Devil Joe can do, right? So, it pretty much has the body of a T-Rex or Godzilla, whatever you want to say. It's a pickle. And it has a bunch of teeth, right? This is the cool part of it. I remember there's this one type of shark I know that I can't remember the name of, but it's this shark. What happens to the shark's jaws and pretty much like any other shark or maybe, no, not crocodiles, it is sharks. What happens is that the teeth on their lower jaw will sometimes get pushed forward and grow in new ones. It'll keep doing that. Like it'll go on and on throughout its lifespan. And wouldn't you know, it's got this whole, like, big chin. Like, it has this whole chin just of these teeth sticking out. The further to its throat the teeth are, the older they are. And it's just been pushed forward and forward and forward and down. And, yeah, it looks creepy, but it's also really awesome. Because they can't. I don't know. They can't, like, brush their teeth. So, like, they just keep growing new ones or something like that. I don't know. I'm going to have to look up the shark, maybe. I'm too lazy to right now. But it's one of my favorites. It's one of my favorite details of it. And plus, here's the thing. Its tail is super big, right? So, in the Monster Hunter games, you can cut off the tails and get a carve out of them. And in the later games, most notably the 4 series and on, you can get, like, tails out of them. Because usually you would just have to fight the monster and probably break the tail, and then you get a higher chance of getting tail. But now you have to cut the tail, and that's how you pretty much get the tails now. Because it makes more sense. It makes more sense. Now, the thing about this pickle, right? It deals high amounts of damage when it gets into an enraged state. It deals more damage quickly. When I was fighting it once in Monster Hunter, I literally almost peed my pants over fighting this monster because of how hard it was and just how brutal it was. I think I streamed it in one episode and I was like, "What the heck?" And I was like, "No! No! No!" And it was just so... I hated the fight. But I love Devil Show. Now, we need to ask. Why is it funny? Why is the pickle funny? So, why the pickle is big funny? Okay, so, there's this kid Morty, right? Yeah. So, there's this dude, right? The scientist also. So... his name is Rick, right? And he turns himself into a pickle. And he names himself Pickle Rick. It's the funniest thing I have ever seen. And that's a meme, all right? If you see, like, a pickle on a thing with someone's face on it, you know, like it's on a table and there's someone's face plastered on it, that is what is called the Pickle Rick. It's one of the things that made pickles just even funnier because it's so stupid. Why does it work? This is my question. This is the thing I really want to dissect one day. Why is the pickle funny? The pickle shouldn't be funny. It should be eaten, not funny. But yet it is funny. It makes people go, "Hee-haw, it is pickle. He pickle equal funny." But I'm like, why is it funny? Can we dissect it? Can we get into why it's funny? What green dotted thing is funny? Guess what? The Hulk is green. He's also funny. So is green just a funny color? But it can also be a scary color. Hence Hulk again and Devil Joe. Both of those things are green and they're scary. Nature is both too. So green. Green. It's both a good thing and a bad thing. Because there's this one character in Mortal Kombat who's named Reptile. And he can shoot acid and stuff. And what is the color of acid in a lot of things? It's like a lighter green. So green can be a color of either pure fear or pure happiness. Green, maybe you have a good health. Green, maybe, I don't know, giant monster with radiation properties. And that's scary. I don't know. What makes Pickles so funny? We're going to figure this out one day. I'm going to have a whole episode or podcast dedicated to just figuring out why the pickle is so funny and so scary, and why green plant fits all these requirements, especially with a dumb joke from a popular show. It's the dumbest joke they could have done, and it still worked. I don't know how. I don't know why. On to the next question that I have on here. Want to hear someone's opinion on why bears are adorable? Guess what? I think bears are cute. I think they're funny, they're fluffy, and they're adorable. And I can't see, like, bears hurt. Like, I can't eat gummy bears. Let me just say that. I cannot eat gummy bears. I cannot. As a kid, I grew up with a teddy bear. I still have my teddy bear. I still have him. I used to call, I call him Ted's, right? I love this bear, dude, so much. This bear was throughout my life. This bear, dude, was like a son or something. He was like a son to me. That's what I called him when I was a kid. I called him my son and stuff. I love this bear so dang much. And if anything were to happen to him, I'd probably kill someone. hypothetically, I'm not doing any crimes. I promise you. I promise you, I'm not evil. I won't kill anyone. Unless it's like in self-defense, you know, that's kind of reasonable, you know, if it's in self-defense. I'm not about to die today. I want the cool death where I'm like old and stuff. I'm not going to die from some stupid idiot with this knife and a gun, you know? Stupid idiot. But like, you know, hypothetically, that's how much that bear cares, like how much it's like attached to me. I can't eat. If anything that involves me eating or hurting a bear, I can't. Unless it's in self-defense of myself, then maybe. But I can't. It's just so ingrained in my mind. Bear is friend. Bear is fluffy. Bear is cute. Haha. Bear go burr, you know? It's so ingrained, you know? You see something you love so much, and it brings up so much memories, you know? It brings up so many good memories, and you just can't. You just can't. It shocks you down to the bone. I'm probably gonna fail the zombie apocalypse, honestly. If every zombie is a bear, I'm gonna fail, dude. I'm gonna absolutely fail the zombie apocalypse if everyone turns into like weird bears somehow. If it's like a bear apocalypse, yeah, if it's a bear apocalypse, I can't do it. I'll try to communicate with them and become their best friends. But in eventuality, I'm gonna be Joe Glass dude, that glass dude from The Revenant, become an actual Revenant, but die and not kill the mom bear. Actually, can we just talk about that scene? Oh my gosh, dude. When I was in, I'd say, fifth, sixth grade? No, yeah, it was somewhere in middle school. Sometime in middle school. English teacher is like, okay, we're talking about, no, it was a history class. I'm sorry, it was a history class, not an English class. Well, I'm talking about a different thing. So, history teacher's like, okay, we're learning about America, right? And they're like, yeah. They're like, okay, so there's this guy named Glass, right? And we're like, yeah. And he was like, there's a whole movie about him. It's all probably not true, but it is also really violent and gory. So I'm going to show you a scene from the movie where a guy gets mauled by a whole bear. That was one of my most exciting moments of my life. I was like, let's go! Because it's a bear. It's a bear ripping up a dude. And let me just tell you, it was awesome watching. Everyone else, they were like, oh, ew, or just like probably scared, like out of their minds. Me, I'm sitting here like, bruh, this is awesome. This is awesome. This whole bear, this whole mother bear ripping this guy's back up. I really wanted to see the guy's like back while he's fighting off the bear. I really want to see the back. I think they did. I just barely couldn't see it for some reason. I don't know. The guy's projector sucked. Let's be honest. But it was great. It was awesome. Sad that the mother bear died. Awesome that we got a whole like episode or like whole class where we got to watch a guy get mauled by a bear. 4K resolution to 1080 60p. Oh, that's so dark, dude. That's so dark. What's something else I can talk about, dude? Oh, man. I love bears so much. I have a whole big teddy bear over here. Y'all can't see it, but there's a whole teddy bear over here. It's so big. My sister, I think I remember, she had, I think she got it from her boyfriend, or she got it for him. But then the guy decided to be, like, a dirtbag to her, and they broke up, which was sad, because I never got to break his kneecaps. Yeah, I told my sister that, and the boyfriend, too. I told her, if he were to break her heart, which he did, which he honestly did, I would break his kneecaps. But now he's, like, up, like, somewhere doing something. So I need to track him down. Get a baseball bat, track him down and break his kneecaps. But that's illegal, and I'm not about to do something illegal right now. So we're gonna have to put that on pending. And also, I have no way of getting there, wherever he may be. So, those are the two reasons. I don't have transportation mostly, and also that I don't know where they are. I probably could. I have his Instagram. What am I talking about? Anyways, she was like, I can't have this bear anymore. I can't have this. It reminds me of him. And I'm like, okay, let me have him. And she's like, okay. So now I have a whole big teddy bear right next to my Steven Universe pillow that my dad won for me at a what was it called? Dave and Buster's. It was from a Dave and Buster's. Bro, dude, Steven Universe, dude, the show took a decline. It took a decline in its last legs, and I was like, oh man, the show, it fell, dude. The first few seasons, they were pretty good. They were really good. Last like seasons after season four, just no, it was no. Movie was weird. No, not doing it. That's this whole weird representation of depression around, like, for the last season, which was called, like, Steven Universe Future. It wasn't good. It wasn't good. Bunch of weird plot points that were stupid. And just, like, making shattering, which is pretty much gem death, pretty much less of a concern and more just, like, a major problem that could be fixed so easily. It's like so stupid. I'm like this was a good plot point. Why did you screw it up like this? Live with the consequences, not like hug and not like fix everything with a hug. It's so dumb. I was like, no, this is why I hated Steven Universe for a good while. Like, this is why I like loathed the show for like a good while until I took a critical lens of it, like a better critical lens of it, more criticism than it was just general hate. Everything has to be fixed by a small child who doesn't know what politics are, nor never got any school education. Literally, Steven has to be like in every episode. There has to be at least like 5 seconds of him in the show, or else the episode is automatically not good or something like that. I don't know. like, or just like there's no episode. I don't know one episode where Steven is not in it whatsoever. And yet he always has to come around and fix the problem, like the majority of the time. And I hate it. I hate it so much. And I know that hate is a strong word, but I just loathe it, dude. It's so, no. You can't have the main character be the fix to all the problems, dude. It's so dumb. It's so stupid. Like, how, like, no. No. One person, look, if you want someone who can fix everything, that... then you're gonna have to make a good convincing story. I mean, Steven Universe was pretty good for a good while until, as I said, the last few parts, the last seasons, and the movie. It was no. It just kind of went from, oh, okay, this is pretty cool, to this isn't good. This isn't good anymore. Honestly, if I were to critique it or whatever, Just let everyone have their chance to shine. Just, and also, just don't be afraid for everyone to just be evil, you know? Just stop solving everything with hugs. What kind of message that sending to people? Especially the fact that a lot of these gem characters are supposed to have mental problems, dude. Like some have PTSD, some have depression, you know? Some are just generally, like, low-key insane and irredeemable most of the time. Unless the plot calls for them to be redeemable, then they are somehow. I'm like, everything can't be solved with a hug, a kiss, or, like, a short, or like, a short and sweet, oh, it doesn't have to be like this. It's so dumb. I'm like, let them figure stuff out. They try to do something like that where everyone fixes their problems without Steven having to be the jury, the judge, jury, and low-key executioner, you know? But even then, they just made it kind of... It wasn't that good. It wasn't that good. It was still stupid. What am I talking about? Now, I want to talk about something else also. I did horror makeup for the first time. I didn't make up for the second time. Second time, actually. For the second time ever for Halloween. Specifically for Halloween. This time, specifically for Halloween. And what I did was that I took toilet paper, used, like, the white Elmer's glue and water to stick it on my face, right? It took me, like, a few days to wash out the glue, but because my beard... Because I have a sick beard that I need to shave. But I don't have a good razor. Because my razor is so dull. Put the toilet paper on my face. I'll probably post a picture on the YouTube version. You can go watch that. If you're here on SoundCloud. And maybe Spotify once I get it up there. Like I used fake blood on it. And then I realized, oh wait, I need to have some part that makes it look like skin. So I got my mom's, like, concealer makeup, put it on the thing, and realized, oh dang it, it's too light, because I'm dark and my mom's, like, whiter. So I have to I had to cover it up in like the fake blood, and it actually worked. It made it darker, and I was like, what? And it worked, and I showed people pictures of it. And they were like, oh, that's sick. That's cool. Whoa. Yankee with no brim. Yeah, it was amazing. I was like, how did I do this? I barely even knew anything about it. But apparently it's very easy. Considering that I did it. It was awesome. So, I don't know. Let's talk about Halloween also. Because that passed. Halloween was such a disappointment, dude. It was such a disappointment. Man, it was so weird. It was so weird. No, actually, it wasn't a disappointment. It was actually pretty chill. But it was disappointing that traditional Halloween stuff didn't occur. But, you know, it was pretty good. Me and my family went hiking or whatever. Dude, I crashed a wedding. I crashed a wedding. It was amazing, dude. It was so sick. So, my mom wanted us, wanted me and my sister to go up hiking, right? And it was a really nice hike. It was a really nice walk. Got to go breathe nature, you know. It was nice and cool. There was no weird criticism being thrown around about my art. No, I'm joking. No. But we were having a nice time. We were having a nice time walking around. I had my music playing a little bit. It was pretty nice. And then I see this one area off in the distance when we're looking over this part, this lake part of the place. And I couldn't help but think, man, that area looks awesome. Because I have no memory of it. If I knew, then I probably forgot. But it looked very, very amazing. And I was like, I need to go look at this place, dude. So I go and look, right? I convinced them, hey, let's go walk around the lake. And while we're walking around the lake, I can go check this spot out. So we did. And I went to check the spot out. And then when I was trying to get into the circle, there's this group of old people, right? And they're looking this one way. And I'm like, why don't y'all just, like, go near the actual, like, deck part? Because there's, like, a little, like, stone deck that I saw that I actually wanted to look on. So I started trying to say, like, scoot by and say, excuse me. One of the old dudes looks towards me, and they're like, they're getting married. I'm like, what? And he's like, they're getting married. And I'm like, who's getting married? And I look over. Oh, my God. It was so cute. These two people were standing there holding hands. This one lady on her phone, like, reading the whole spiel of like we're here in matrimony, kiss the bride thing, you know. And I'm sitting here like, what? There's a whole dang marriage over here. This is so cool. Like, whoa. How? Like it's so cool, you know. The one thing I noticed from this, you know, they're getting married, right? But the thing is that they didn't choose, like, a whole venue. They didn't get a whole nice, like, suits or, whatchamacallits, dresses and do the whole thing, you know, rent out maybe, like, a big old church or whatever to do it. Nah. No, this is a good teaching moment, dude. This was a good teaching moment. You don't need big old fancy stuff to have a good life, to have a good time, you know? You don't need to, like, over-exaggerate everything. You don't need to spend $50 million on this whole dream wedding that might not even go as planned, you know? It's just these two people genuinely who look like, I don't know if they're just getting married just to get married or whatever, but, like, these two seem like they genuinely did not care that they had a bad budget. Who knows? Maybe they planned it that way. Maybe they planned that they were not going to make a big deal out of it and spend $50 million or something investing in, like, the perfect marriage on the beach or whatever. They just did it where they thought, hey, this looks nice, you know, this looks beautiful, this place is already great. Maybe that same spot was where they, like, had their first date, dude, you know. There's so many possibilities to why they chose that spot. Maybe they hiked up there and they're thinking, oh, dude, this is such a great spot, this is such a great view, or they shared a great memory there. Heck, maybe that's how they met in the first place. Maybe they just were hiking up there. They both just happened to come across each other on that part, you know. Got to talk, got to become, like, friends. And then eventually, you know, love blossomed. A whole ring got pulled out. She said yes, and they got married. And it was just, I was only there for a few seconds, but I could already, like, get some kind of special lesson out of this. You don't need to go big and bombastic to be really fantastic. I just stole a quote from Biggie Cheese. I stole a quote from Biggie Cheese, of all people, a rat from a kid, from a show, from a Nickelodeon TV movie or something. Oh my gosh. I stole a quote from back at the Barnyard. But the point still stands. I guess this is the lesson of, I guess we have a whole, like, lesson now. We just have to have at least one lesson in, like, every podcast. The lesson here is that don't, the man who has everything, has nothing. And the people who have nothing already have everything. You know? That is one of those kinds of lessons. Or maybe it's just, like, don't waste your money. Don't waste your money on something big when the thing that you should invest. Yeah, let's do that. Okay, here's the better version of the lesson. Don't spend your money on don't invest in, shoot, I'm trying to, hold on. I already have it in my head. I'm trying to communicate it. Hold up. Don't invest in formalities and everything to make yourself look better, but invest in the relationship y'all have. You know, there we go. It's kind of half crap, but you get it. You get it. We spent, like, I don't know, 3 minutes trying to figure out what I was trying to say, what the lesson of the day was, even though it was really clearly out there. It took me 3 whole minutes, probably. I don't know. I'm gonna have to look back, but you know. It's pretty cool. Now, we got, like, a good, I don't know, maybe 20 minutes left. So I want to talk about more things, probably. And one of these more things that I really want to talk about. Are they video games? Yes. I really want to talk about video games so badly, dude. Oh, man. I don't get why people don't play too many video games, you know? It's a whole industry. You have fun, and they have so many options to choose from. Y'all have so many choices to choose from video games, and y'all people barely ever even play them. You want to have a fast-paced game where you're beating up, like, demons and stuff? Oh, cool. Maybe you want to play Devil May Cry or Doom, you know? Play one of those two games. There's even more with that kind of subsection. You want to play a game where you get to go bang bang with a gun to people? Boom. Maybe play Doom and play Call of Duty or something. Or maybe even, like, I don't know, Titanfall. That's pretty cool. Or, better yet, do you want to save the world, the universe, from aliens using advanced technology? Boom. Maybe play Halo, maybe play Mass Effect, you know. Those are valid games to play. Or maybe you're not one of those, like, action-packed people and you just want to relax. Boom. Animal Crossing. I don't know, maybe those stupid mobile games where you just do those whole, like, Connect 3 kind of things. I don't know, like Candy Crush maybe. Those weird fixer-upper games. I don't know. Mobile games are weird. Also, I wanted to say this. I wanted to talk about something that was in modern media. Here's our Twitter talk of the day, or of the podcast, dude. Right. So there's this person that does this thing called redraws, right? What are redraws? So, let's say someone drew a piece of art, whether it's fan art or it's legitimately art, or maybe it's like an animated character or something, or whatever, in a comic book, an anime, just like an animated movie or show, etc. And then someone says, yo, I hate this. Why did you make it this way? Or, man, this is so terribly designed. I don't like this one bit, you know, I don't like this character. So let me just make them the way I want them. And usually it would be some kind of form of political correction, which is really disgusting and disturbing. Enter this kid called Z Fixes Art or something. So this person is apparently an artist, right? And this artist, let's just say that her redraws, they're not good. They're not good. Z Fixes Art, their art is not good. And what they do with the redraws is equally terrible. Or if not more. So what did they do? What did this person do? Why did they offend the internet? I don't know. Call it trolling. Call it genuine stupidity, probably. This kid thought, yes, let's take a bunch of anime characters and turn them into desexualized and less, like desexualized and not so whatever people, more diverse people. What do they always draw them as? Okay, so let's say characters from My Hero Academia. That was one of their culprits. Those were some of their culprits, or like their victims, not culprits. They are the culprit, and they're doing stuff against the victims. Yeah. So there were these characters from My Hero Academia. They're all like girls and stuff. Pretty much, they're all the same kind of girl. They're all these Japanese, they're all these like young teenage Japanese girls. They all have like their different body structures. One of them's taller, one of them's shorter. The other one has more frog features, but they still look like a Japanese anime girl. There's nothing really wrong with them, and the fact that they're all Japanese girls is because they're all from Japan. My Hero Academia literally takes place in Japan, where Japanese people are, where the ratio of like races there is pretty much the majority Japanese. So you're more likely going to see Japanese characters than anyone else. Anyone that's white, anyone that's black, maybe even Filipino, you know? You don't really get to see much Filipino representation. And I'm pretty sure you want to see a lot of Filipinos there, because Filipinos are mostly like either in like, I don't know, America, or mostly, you know, the Philippines. Duh. I'm stupid. Guess what they decide to do? It doesn't even matter. It doesn't even matter. All these characters are just anime characters who are all Japanese. Most of them that I know are from Japan, you know, in their art style, the anime art style depicts them as being whiter, you know, not to be racist with the whole like yellow skin thing, you know, that's not really cool. But what Z Fixes Art does is that they say, yeah, let's desexualize them and stuff by making them all black, making them fat, literally. Yeah, that's literally their whole stance. Just they took all these Japanese characters and made them all black and fat, which is really not cool. It's so dumb. It's so stupid. If anything, they're making it even more racist than it should be, and even more demoralizing to like fatter people, right? You already got no, and it's funny because they're like anti-fat phobic or something like that, and yeah, anti-fat phobic or something, and yet they're demoralizing them by saying that they're being desexualized, and that they're all being, yeah, if they're all being depicted as desexualized and they're all depicted as being fat, it's kind of hypocrisy at its finest. Oh, let's make this less racist and more diverse by making them all black or Muslim or whatever, like any race with a dark skin, and then make them all fat. It's a blow. It's a accidental low blow, or it's just really stupid trolling. And let's just do this again. They applied the same logic to another artist's art. This person being known as Creepshow Art. You probably heard of them if you're in the art ring. They make commentary videos and also make art. Apparently, they fix one of their artworks. You know, they, well, quote unquote, in air quotes, fixed their artwork. And what they did was that they took the artwork, the person in the artwork, and applied the same type of mindset that they did onto them. And yeah, this wasn't a Japanese person. This was like a white character now. This was a white character. Which is kind of bullcrap considering that the sketch was of a real person. A real person. So the sketch was of this actually real white person with the muscular frame. And nothing was even wrong with the art. I wouldn't say that anything's wrong with the art. You know, it looked really nice. There was nothing wrong with it. And it's not like it was Abigail or that one Jenny boss from like, that one zombie game. And also when I say Abigail, I mean like Abby from Last of Us 2. That's already train wreck. Don't get me started on that. But the fact that she said, oh, I fixed it, applied the same knowledge. And the fact that they did this with the sketch that that Creepshow Art even said was a commission by a real person of a real person. And the fact that they were actually white and stuff, it just makes it worse. And the fact they were so snarky about fixing it. They're pretty much like, this was stupid. I fixed it by making them black, or Muslim, or fat, or whatever, dark skin, you know. It's not cool. It's not cool. And apparently, it was so not cool to everyone. Here's the kicker. Here's the funny part. They got hacked. They got hacked, dude. And it was so... And like, everyone was like, oh, thank God. And oh my goodness, at the same time. Because let's just say that the hacker, they... I think they went too far. They probably went too far, but at least we don't have to see more of the technically atrocities based on this one person. And just taking a whole slice and note on Twitter and redraws in one fell swoop with a few words. It's stupid. It's stupid, dude. It's stupid, dude. This is why I don't have Twitter, because they have all this trash on it. You got all these blue check marks, like literally being like simps to the algorithm, you know. Wherever the people sway, the blue check marks are sure to follow and kiss up to, because they want to keep their public image correct and they want to keep their blue check mark and all their viewers. This is why I don't like it, because those bigger social medias are just breeding grounds for terrible things. And it turns out there are all these allegations of these formerly cool people are now like pedos or something. It's disgusting. I'm like, what has this world even come to? You know? I'm being like legit dead serious with this. And yes, I just named the title. Thank you for pointing out. So, yeah, to wrap this up, if you're going to be a terrible person, then just don't. Live a good life. Don't care about being verified by the public. Just care that you're doing the right thing, because you know, because it's not, live life because you're not trying to kiss up to everyone by doing good things, but by doing good things because you know that it's morally right and that you're not just doing it for the attention, for the good, for the good marks, and so then you're not on the naughty list of like God's or Santa Claus's naughty list. Just don't, you know. So we're wrapping up the podcast here. Maybe it was good. Maybe it was terrible. Maybe y'all want to give me some criticism on things that I've said, or maybe I've spread some low-key misinformation, or maybe you just have some valid thoughts and opinions on this little whiz-bang shing-lang that I've just done. Also, I'll be adding in an outro for my podcast. The song is called Look Through My Eyes from Brother Bear, performed by Phil Collins. And the funny thing is that the thumbnail for this season of my podcast is based on a Phil Collins track or album known as Face Values. And Face Values is actually based on his experience with his wife having an affair with him. His first wife having an affair with him. I don't know how many wives he'd had. I don't know. He's a pretty cool dude. So, finally wrapping this up. Actually wrapping and finalizing this. Thank you for coming here. Thank you for listening. And if you want to hear more, then just subscribe to me. Or follow me on whatever you hear this on. I am the 13th Revenant, or as you may know, Kyle. Goodbye. Have a good life.
There are things in life you learn, and in time you'll see. 'Cause out there somewhere, it's all waiting if you keep it.